Anyone who's looked at the episode number might think that I've got something special planned. However, it's just going to be a beer with a good head on it. Meanwhile, in mailbag world, we have something that has a description written in Chinese, but it says it's 50 American cents. So let's see what that really is. Pink and white stuff. Okay. Okay. Coily stuff. Is that coil kind of joined together there? Is there any other join in this? Are these... Anybody guessed what this is yet? Okay, so there is a kind of a join in it there. And, what this is, or what they sold it as, is cord protector. You're supposed to wrap it around the cord to add some stiffness and rigidity. And presumably you have to cut it somewhere so that you... that's what it's supposed to be for. Protector for USB charging cable, protective accessory, charger cable saver, 10 pieces from Perfect 277. I got this at auction for 60 cents Canadian for the 10 pieces, so 6 cents each, with free shipping, of course. Currently, they're selling them for $2.24 for some reason. I'm not super convinced, and it's decorative, I guess. I suppose it makes it a little bit harder to bend the cable, which might prevent it from kinking and pulling out. I'm not sure. But, I don't know. They're colorful anyways. I think that's probably the one that I got. Not sure if I'm going to use them, but one of them might end up on my daughter's phone. Maybe on my wife's phone, because her cord gets yoinked a fair bit. I don't know. What do you think? Have you played with one of these things before? All right. Next thing says 3-volt to 5-volt. 3-watt mono micro audio power. If it's not lying to me, that could be Odo audio amplifier. Holy shit, that's small. You're gonna need to zoom in to look at this. Okay, does it say anything on there at all? NS 8002 1645. That's just a date code version 1. It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pins across the bottom. We've got the IC, 4 capacitors and 2 resistors, and that is it.
DC 3-volt to 5-volt, 3.7-volt, 8002 3-watt mono micro audio power amplifier board EB sound amp module. Best for sell is who I bought this thing from. Currently selling here, $1.31. I got it at auction for 40 cents with free shipping. What does it say? Power amplifier board, class AB efficient. Interesting. I would have expected class D digital amp, but whatever. It's a mono 3-watt amp. 48 ohm impedance speaker. Frequency response 150 hertz to 20k, so not hi-fi bottom end, but not bad, decent high end. Board should be grounded 3 feet for the power supply. Entirely trustworthy. Says you can run it off a 3.7 volt lithium battery. That could be interesting. Oh look, it's a data sheet. Income Technology. Did they actually just say we're only in it for the money? Interesting. The 8002 is an audio power amplifier. 3 watts into a 3 ohm load. Less than 10% distortion. Wow, from 5 volts. Okay. Does not require output coupling capacitors, bootstrap capacitors, so it's good for low voltage applications. So there's the typical application circuit for the chip. Chip itself, an 8-ohm speaker. What does that look like? That looks like a feedback resistor, an input resistor, one capacitor there, one bypass capacitor there, and a resistor. So the board that I got's got a little bit more on it than that, probably a couple of extra bypass caps, but other than that, that's pretty much it. Okay, so I've got this guy hooked up to power and audio input from my little thing there, and the little 8-ohm speaker. Power's coming from this 18650. So let's hook it up and see what happens. That sounds like a win. I mean, yeah, it's not a high quality speaker, it's not a high quality amplifier, but for putting in something really small, that could come in handy for stuff, I guess. Don't know what yet, but it was only, what, 60 cents? I'll take it. Next in, we have solder wire clip. Okay. Okay, adhesive back, 3M. Actual 3M? Wow. Adhesive back little wire clips. What is that? That is like a double-sided foam tape kind of stuff. And these are just little cable management clips. You stick them onto something and you put a cable in, like so, just to kind of hold it neat and tidy out of the way. I'm thinking some of these are going to go behind the computer desk in the family room upstairs.
18 pieces, powerful sticky wall holder, desktop cable clip organizer wire management. I got these from Best Home Store 18 for 99 cents, and 18 of them in black. For that's not too bad a deal. There's not really a lot to say about them. They're sticky back. Okay, that's a little bit carried away. That's more reasonable though.
Okay, this one came from within Canada. I didn't order it from Canada. I ordered it from China. They paid $3 shipping on it. I'm pretty confident that I wouldn't have. And it is an HDMI cable. 10-foot, a.k.a. 3-point, slightly more than that, meters HDMI cable. Seems to be reasonable quality. I mean, HDMI cables, unlike analog cables, are either they work or they don't. It's a digital cable. It's a little stiff. What does that say on the cable jacket? High-speed HDMI cable with Ethernet. Not much else to say about that. Connectors are reddish. Okay. These days, HDMI is an increasingly handy cable to have a few of whenever you're changing things around, and especially if you can find a good deal on them.
Ultra high quality HDMI 1.4 cable, 1080p Ethernet, ARC, HDTV 3, various different footages. I got the 10 foot with the two ferrite cores. It looks exactly like that one. Came from Jennings Gate, which is actually in Canada. I got this at auction for $1.35 with free shipping. That's why I bought it. That's an okay-ish price, but $1.35 at auction, how can you go wrong? You know, if you see an auction for something that's ending soon and the price is pretty low, it doesn't hurt to put in a stupidly lowball bid. I mean, it doesn't cost you anything if you don't win it, but occasionally you'll get lucky. What do we have here? Certified HDMI 1.4B. It's
between got 28 to 32 gauge wire in it. It's got Ethernet and audio return channel. Yeah. It's an HDMI cable. What else do you need to know? And the last thing is the ever popular expansion board module. I wonder what kind it is. It's very power supply-ish, doesn't it? We've got ins out there, we got outs over there. We have three potentiometers on it. Do they say what they are doing? Nope, just SW1, SW2, and SW3. I am going to guess one of them is voltage, one of them is probably current limit, and I don't know what the other one is. The listing, maybe it'll tell you. 1/2/5 times DC to DC auto, step up, step down, boost buck converter module, LM2577S, LM2596S power. I got the one piece for $3.94 from Good Module with free shipping. So it's a buck and boost converter. Interesting. I think I know why I got this. Input voltage, 4 to 35 volts. Output continually adjustable between 1.2 and 25 volts. Output current, 3 amps max. Constant current range, there we go, 0 to 2 amps. What is the other adjustment? Constant current is red. Charging indicator is also red. Charge completed indicator is blue. Short circuit protection, yes, it does constant current, sure. In, out, out. Applications. Lithium battery charging. Ding, 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 ding. I think this is the final piece of the puzzle for my drill battery conversion. You know, the ill-advised one on the free battery that I got, the free drill I got last year. I really got to figure out what that third control is for, though. Okay, let's play with this thing a little bit here. We've got 9 volts coming in over here. Input, output to this meter. So that's 4 volts. What did it say the blue was? The blue was current limit? That's interesting because we shouldn't be current limiting. Okay, so that's the voltage. With 9 volts in, being a buck boost, we should be able to get more out. Okay. What's that one do? Eek. Doesn't seem to be making any difference at all. Okay. I wonder what happens if we put a load on it. Oh, wait a minute. I just took a look. Just took another look, and the blue light means charge complete, which would mean it's not drawing any current. So those aren't listed or aren't labeled as to what they mean, but we got some kind of a load on there now. So drawing about 275 milliamps from the input side. So I'm guessing 300, 375. Okay, so this should, there we go, we had our constant current. You see that other LED come on down there when that happens? Okay, so somewhere in around there, that's set for 14 volts across 100 ohms. You do the math if you want. But I can set up this thing then to current limit at whatever I want for charging a lithium ion pack, and set the constant voltage and constant current for that. And also the shutoff current, I guess. That is going to work out just about perfect for my needs. for, as I said, converting this beast here to salvaged lithium ion batteries from old laptops. Is it going to be efficient? Nope. Is it going to be fun? Of course. And here is the totality of this week's Mailbag Monday items. Shipping times. These sticky, clippy things took 11 weeks to get here. My God. This HDMI cable took about a week because it came from within Canada, so that's completely not surprising. This weird cable protector stuff took a month. This itty-bitty amplifier chip took a month. And the buck boost converter took a month. Exactly 4 weeks, actually. So that's not too bad. Except for these things. 11 weeks, what the hell. Hope you enjoyed watching. As usual, if you got anything to say, your questions, comments, complaints, down in the comments section, as usual, I'll be down there to respond or ignore you as appropriate. Thanks to my Patreon supporters for helping me finance my silliness. There's a link down in the comments if you're feeling extra generous. Not necessary, but I do appreciate each and every one of those guys. Thanks, everybody. I will talk to you later.